We all know that the Bible expresses the will of God. The Bible is the word of God. The Bible is what God is saying. Although it is the written word, it does not differ from the saying word. There is no saying word of God or prophecy that can contradict the Bible. When any prophecy or saying word of God contradicts the Bible, you know that is not from God. The Bible is the authentic word of God that does not fail, cannot fail, will never fail. Good morning. You are welcome to I Prevail with Joseph Adenuga. This morning again, as usual, the Almighty God has put a word in my mouth to speak to you, to encourage you, to motivate you, and to inspire you. And this morning I pray, Almighty God will touch you. Almighty God will rejuvenate you. He will fill you with power and divine ability to do great things. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. This morning I just want to talk about the love of God. The Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 5 from verse 1. It says, anyone that believes in Jesus Christ is born of God. Whosoever believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God is born of God. You see, that one is a fact. It's a true statement. Anyone that believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God is born of God. That is what Romans chapter 10, verses 9 and 10 tells us. He said, if you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and that he died, and you confess with your mouth that God have raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Salvation is as simple as ABC. In fact, salvation is the simplest, the greatest blessing on earth. Number one, salvation is the greatest blessing on earth. That's number one. Number two, salvation is the simplest thing, the simplest, greatest thing to accomplish. Because it only takes you to believe that Jesus Christ is Lord, you will be saved. The Bible says, and your family. Hallelujah. But the point of my message this morning is really not that. The point of my message is found in 1 John chapter 5, verse 4, where the Bible says, whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world. That's King James Version. I began to ask myself this question. Why is the Bible saying whatsoever is born of God? Because we know that it is human being that can be born of God. Why is God saying whatsoever? Because when you say whatsoever, you are including inanimate things. You are including things that are non-living things. So when the Bible says whatsoever is born of God, it's not just talking about human beings. Because he could have said, whosoever is born of God. I think that would have been the most appropriate word to use in that context. That whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. But the Bible did not say, whosoever is born of God. The Bible actually said, whatsoever is born of God. There is no mistake in the Bible. What is God trying to say? God is trying to say that anyone that is born of God, including everything that you have, your home, your property, because you are born of God, your property is now born of God. Because you have believed that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Because you have believed that Jesus Christ came, he died, and he rose again for our justification. When you believe like that, you are born of God. Everything that belongs to you is born of God. Your car is born of God. Your house is born of God. Your property is born of God. Your clothes are born of God. This is the reason why when people touch our clothes, they get healed. This is the reason why handkerchiefs from us, when we lay hands on those handkerchiefs, they become miraculous handkerchiefs. Anything that belongs to you is born of God. Simply for the reason of the fact that you are born of God. Everything of yours becomes born of God. That means that that business of yours cannot fail. Because you are born of God, that business is born of God. Those children of yours cannot go wayward. Because you are born of God, those children are born of God. The clothes, everything that you have is born of God for the simple fact that you are born of God. Whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. So God is saying, when you are born of God, you must have faith, not just for you, but for your things. When you are born of God, you must have faith, not just for your salvation that you will go to heaven, but for the things that you do on this earth. Your faith must stretch from you to your things. It must stretch to your business. It must stretch to your family. It must stretch to your home. It must stretch to your belongings. I remember one day somebody came, stole my tablet in the church office. I simply said, whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. My tablet has overcome those thieves, so tablet come back home. And within few hours, it came back home. Whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. Your phone is born of God. It's overcometh the world. No thief can steal that phone. Hallelujah. Whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. And verse 5 says, who is he that overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus Christ is the Son of God? Now, he's telling us the qualification for us to claim victory. The qualification is for us to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. So it's as simple as ABC. Do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God? I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And so I am born again. God has given me power to overcome the world. I overcome wickedness. I overcome sickness. I overcome disease. I overcome every arrow of wickedness. I am more than conquerors through Christ that strengthens me. And so are you. This morning, I want you to rise up and begin to declare dangerous decrees. I want you to rise up this morning and begin to speak dangerous words. I want you to rise up this morning and begin to claim your victory in Christ Jesus. You are more than conquerors. You overcome the world. You are more than conquerors. You are healed of that sickness. You are healed of that disease. You are blessed of God. You are going higher. The Lord is on your side. God is fighting your battle. That battle must fall down before you. You are more than conquerors. Hallelujah. You receive that money. You are blessed. This is the message this morning. You have overcome the world. Hear it again. Believe it. Proclaim it with your mouth. It's yours. Thank you, partners, for being with me, sponsoring us, sending your hard-hand money. God will reward you. If you are listening to this for the first time and you love me to send it directly to you, just save my number. Save it with I Prevail. My number is +27 7403 02 381. Save it right now. Go to your WhatsApp. Send me a message and let the message be add me. From tomorrow, you will receive this. Thank you so much. It is well with your soul. Once again, my name is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Springstown, Johannesburg, South Africa, signing out this morning and saying to you, be blessed and remain blessed.